Salmonella, part 1. The salmonella is a genus which causes diseases like enteric fever, gastroenteritis and septicemia with or without the focal suppuration and the carrier state. The most important member of the genus Salmonella is Salmonella typhi, which causes typhoid fever, as we all know. The genus Salmonella is divided into two groups, typhoidal Salmonella and non-typhoidal Salmonella. The typhoidal Salmonella includes enteric fever group, that is those which cause enteric fever, that is typhoid and paratyphoid bacilli. These are exclusively or primarily human parasites. Next group is non-typhoidal Salmonella, which are food poisoning group. They are animal parasites which can also infect humans. They cause gastroenteritis, septicemia or local infections in humans. Coming to the morphology of Salmonella, they are gram-negative bacilli. They are motile with the help of peritrichate flagella, that is flagella present all over the body. Exception is Salmonella gallinarum and Salmonella pullorum. These two are always non-motile. The Salmonella gallinarum and Salmonella pullorum are always non-motile, and the other species of Salmonella are motile with peritrichate flagella. The organisms are non-capsulated and non-sporing. They may have fimbriae and they are aerobic or facultatively anaerobic. Culture characteristics of Salmonella. The Salmonellae are aerobic and facultatively anaerobic. Let's see their growth in different types of culture media. First is Meconchie agar. They produce non-lactose fermenting pale colonies. In deoxycholate citrate agar, known as DCA, and xylose lysine deoxycholate agar, XLD. In these two agars, the Salmonella produces black-headed colonies. The black color is due to H2S production. In Wilson and Blair bismuth sulfite medium, the Salmonella produces jet black colonies with metallic sheen. Even here, the black color is due to production of H2S. The selenate F broth and the tetrathionate broth are used as enrichment media for Salmonella. The culture media used are Meconchie agar, in which non-lactose fermenting pale colonies are produced, DCA and XLD agar, in which black-headed colonies are produced due to H2S production, Wilson and Blair bismuth sulfite medium, in which jet black colonies with metallic sheen are produced, with the black color is due to H2S production, and the selenate F broth and the tetrathionate broth are used as enrichment media. The biochemical reactions. The Salmonella ferments glucose, mannitol and maltose, forming both acid as well as gas. The exception for it is the most important member, Salmonella typhi. The Salmonella typhi is anaerogenic, so the lactose, sucrose and salicylin are not fermented. Imbictus. Imbic stands for indole, methyl red, VP test and citrate utilization. The Imbic tests are negative, positive, negative, positive. So indole is negative, M is positive, VP test is negative and citrate utilization is positive. Urea is not hydrolyzed and H2S is produced. Exception for this is Salmonella paratyphi A, which does not produce H2S. So Salmonella paratyphi A does not produce H2S and the other species produce hydrogen sulfide gas. Antigenic structure. The four main antigenic structures seen in Salmonella are the flagellar antigen, that is H antigen, somatic antigen, O antigen, surface antigen, VI antigen, and fimbrial antigen, F antigen. Surface antigen is found only in some species. Let's see all the four one by one. First is H antigen, which is present on the flagella. So it is called as flagellar antigen. It is a heat labile protein and it is strongly immunogenic. So it induces antibody formation rapidly and in high titers following any infection or immunization. Second is O antigen, that is somatic antigen, present in the cell body. It is a phospholipid protein polysaccharide complex and it is similar to the endotoxin, that is lipopolysaccharide. This O antigen is known as Bovin antigen because it was first shown by a scientist called Bovin. The antibody to O antigen is cross-reactive, while the antibody to H antigen is more reliable indicator. Next is VI antigen, that is surface antigen. It is a surface polysaccharide antigen enveloping the O antigen. So this VI antigen covers the O antigen. It is analogous to the K antigens of the coliforms. This VI antigen is heat labile and the VI polysaccharide acts as a virulence factor by inhibiting phagocytosis, resisting complement activation and bacterial lysis by alternate pathway and peroxide mediated killing. The VI antigen, that is the surface antigen, is poorly immunogenic. So there is only low titers of antibodies are produced following infection. The VI antibody detection is not helpful for diagnosis. Hence, VI antigen is not employed in Weidel test. The antibody disappears early in convalescence. If the VI antibody persists, this indicates carrier state. Let's now see about the antigenic variations. The antigens of Salmonella undergo phenotypic and genotypic variations. First is HO variation. This is associated with loss of flagella when the Salmonella are grown on agar containing phenol. The flagella are inhibited. This change is phenotypic and it is temporary. The flagella reappears when the strain is subcultured on the media without phenol. Rarely, the Salmonella may lose their flagella by mutation. A stable non-motile mutant of Salmonella typhi, that is the 901O strain, is used for the preparation of O-agglutinable bacterial suspensions. Phase variation. The flagellar antigens occur in one of the two phases, that is the flagella may exhibit one or the other of two alternative sets of antigens defined by two separate sets of genes in the bacterial genome. The two phases are, first is phase 1 antigens, which are either specific for a species or shared by only few species only. So this phase 1 is called as specific phase. The next is phase 2 antigens, which are widely shared by many species. So this phase 2 is called as non-specific or group phase. Some strains can possess both the phases, specific phase as well as group phase. They are called as diphasic strains, and some like Salmonella typhi occur only in one phase. So they are called as monophasic strains. The next variation is VW variation. The fresh isolates of Salmonella typhi have surface antigen VI, which completely masks the O antigen. So they are agglutinable with VI antiserum, but they are not agglutinable with O antiserum, as the O antigen is masked by VI antigen. Such forms are called as V form. After number of subcultures, the VI antigen is completely lost. So now these subcultures are not agglutinable with VI antigen, as the VI antigen is completely lost, but they are readily agglutinable with O antiserum because now the O antigen is visible. Such forms are called as W forms. So these are V forms and these are W forms. In intermediate stages, the bacillus is agglutinable with both VI as well as O antisera. Such forms are called as VW forms, both V and W. So VW forms. The last type of variation is SR variation. SR stands for smooth to rough. So smooth to rough variation is also associated with change in colony morphology and loss of O antigen and loss of virulence. The colony becomes large, rough and irregular. Coming to the pathogenicity, the Salmonella are strict parasites of animals or humans. Salmonella typhi, Salmonella paratyphi A and usually Salmonella paratyphi B. They are confined to humans, whereas the Salmonella typhi murium has wide host range, so it affects animals, birds as well as humans. Salmonella can cause the following clinical syndromes in humans. They include enteric fever, gastroenteritis or food poisoning, and septicemia with or without local suppurative lesions. We'll see about all these in detail in our next part of video. Thank you.